International Women's Day is an opportunity, I think, to reflect and take stock on whether we are doing enough to support our female colleagues in science, and particularly those who are more junior and who are coming behind us and wanting to have careers in science.
The theme of accelerated action really reminds us of how important it is to change the policies quickly, because clearly we're not doing enough, that we still need to have this theme of accelerated action.
We've been talking about disparities between men and women in science for a very long time, and if these disparities still exist, then probably we should be doing more about it more quickly than we are.
The World Economic Forum estimated that for gender equality to be established, we need 5 generations from this point, and we have to wait more than 100 years to see the effect. So accelerate action, for sure.
We all know that when there is an obvious case of discrimination, it's actually quite easy to put your finger on it. What's much more difficult is all the microaggression, the small problem on a day-to-day basis. It's a problem really with awareness and bias, both unconscious and implicit, and it starts extremely early during our education.
When you hit the leadership positions, the professorship positions, is where the disparity becomes so obvious.
Women face, I think, structural and cultural biases. There are ideas of what women should behave like or what they are like. There's distinction in which women and men are perceived, and this perception feeds into academia. And we see that all the time, as women are trying to transition into more independent positions, positions of leadership. These biases stick around in places they shouldn't.
The University of Oxford has been very rich in supporting me at various stages of training.
I've been on a Women in Leadership course run here in the Wetherall Institute, and that was absolutely brilliant to have a group of women who were talking together about the challenges and how leadership skills can be gained, and we had coaching as part of that, and that was extremely helpful.
One of the initiatives that I personally found very, very useful for me, and that was specifically when I came back from my maternity leave, was the Carers Fund. This was a small application that you could put in for a small grant, but having that little bit extra, and also having the sense that you had gotten a grant after being away from your life in academia for 5-6 months, I found it just meant more than just the small grant that it was.
So there's many women who have impressed me and have made a huge difference for me. I mean, the first one remains the same, it's my mother. She's the most fantastic person, very inspiring, and one of the best advocates. Silent in the way that she does it, but it has been constant, because quite clearly, if we want to get to some level of equity, equality, it's a marathon, it's not a sprint. It's something that needs to be done constantly, reassuring people that they're on the right track.
A woman who's really inspired me is my postdoc supervisor. She really showed that you just don't have to be limited. And you don't have to think about, I'm a woman. You just don't have to do that in an academic environment.
The key aspect, if you want to do a career, is education, education, education. But that doesn't come just with that. It's the whole package. It's mentoring. It's constant attention to the barriers that are in front of you. The only way forward is just get on with it, dream big, do it, and make sure that you have the right ally, the support around you that allows you to make it possible. But you're not alone.